Hello friends, now we have to talk about application layer of computer networking part second of TYBCS. We are familiar with the application layer. We know that application layer is the one of the topmost layer in ISO OSI and TCP/IP layered model there. The application layer has its own responsibility, that is to provide services to the user and user applications there. So this application layer is basically responsible to provide services to the user and user application there. So application layer provide user interface and support for services such as DNS, that is domain name system there. Then for the email, so this application layer provides the user interfaces support for the services like DNS, email, file transfer, and there is access for surfing the world wide web and network management there also. So in this chapter we have to discuss the services supported by the application layers. I have told you that what the application layer is the topmost, that is the fifth layer of internet model, and this layer where all the interesting applications are found on the web there. The application layer provide the services to the user. The user can be human or software there. It enable the user to access the network. If we look toward this model, then it is found that application layer is stable at the topmost. So that's why we have said that it is the topmost layer of internet model. So for that purpose, in application layer, it support the services we have seen, but which services? That is the domain name system, DNS. So application layer support the several applications there that follow the client and server environment. So client and server programs that can be divided into two categories there. That is the programs which are directly used by user, like email, and the those that are support other application program there. Here there is a DNS which is a supporting program which is used by other applications. Which application? The applications like the email. And we know that, but network layer provides there is a unique identification and the source to destination delivery of host on the internet. For this, network layer uses its own IP protocol for source to destination delivery of data and the IP addressing for the unique identification. For the unique identification, it gives us, there is a IP address. We are familiar with the concept of IP address there. People prefer to use the names instead of numeric address there. Therefore, we need to system that can be mapped name to the address or address to the name there. When internet was small, mapping was done by using the host pipe. Every host stores these host files on the its disk there and update it periodically from the master file. This file had two columns there. One column is name and other column is the address. And when a program or a user want to map the name to address, the host is consulted the host file and found the mapping there. So today, the size of internet is so large and growing it day by day there. And to store on every host, it is the difficult task. So it would also be impossible to update all host files every time there was a change. So for this difficulty, there is a one solution. And the one solution to these large files is, instead of storing the host file on every computer, on the single computer, and allows access to the centralized information to every computer who needs the mapping there. But it will create the large traffic on the internet, and the number of users will not get the mapping. So this solution also not works there. So another solution is, instead of storing this huge information on the single computer, divide this huge information into the smaller parts and store each part of the different computer. The host that needs the mapping can contact to the closest computer. This is nothing but the domain name system, and that is the DNS. So for communication takes place successfully, sender and receiver both should have addresses and they should be known to each other. The application program uses the ally's name instead of IP address. So the ally's address has to be mapped to the IP address. For this application program, need the service of another entity. This entity is an application program, that is the DNS, means domain name system, which is the mechanism that assign easy to remember the names. Easy to remember the names means domain is the large group of computers on the internet. Under the scheme, each computer has an IP address and the domain name also. So domains have on the base of organization type or the geographical locations. That is, the domain name is like google.com, where .com indicates that Google is commercial organization. What indicates? Google is commercial organization there. So like this, there is a ARPA, COM, AJU, ORG, AD, up to ZW. There are the lot of names there. For example, COM is a commercial again also there is a com. .com is for commercial organizations. Then for cooperative business, there is a CWOP, EDU for the educational institutions. Then the info is for information service providers. Then also for international organizations, there is INT for military, there is military groups for MIL. For museums and other non-profit organizations, their MUSI. Personal names for individuals, like there is a name. Network support centers, there is a NET. ORG for non-profit organization. PR for professional individual organization. So these are the number of generic domains which are used to represent the websites. So I hope that you have understand this part. Under the application layer there. So thank you so much.